Well, Daniel Jones got social media buzzing with his legs last night, even drawing comparison to our friend as, quote, Vanilla Vic was trending after his long touchdown run got called back due to a penalty. We are now joined by Fox Sports NFL analyst Michael Vick. Were you offended that Daniel Jones was compared to you?
Offended? Absolutely not. That only enhances my legacy. I appreciate it, Daniel Jones. Thank you, Daniel Jones. But for him, man, just to, anytime I see a quarterback break outside of the pocket, especially on a zone run, a guy like Daniel Jones, where you don't expect to see that, and that was shocking to everybody. But he did it last year, showed that he had some wheels. If he do more running than throwing, he might stick around for a longer period of time in the National Football League. But shout out to Daniel Jones. It was an amazing run, and I hope to see more of that out of him throughout the rest of the season.
Okay, Michael, go bigger picture now, because my partner across the table and I go back and forth. I got the Cowboys. He's got the field in the NFC East. You got your Eagles. You got Washington last night. You even have Daniel Jones. Right now, who is the best team that you have seen so far in the NFC East?
Right now, I got to go with the Philadelphia Eagles. Ooh. And, you know, I'm not being biased. I'm just telling the truth. You know, they went into Atlanta last week and they took care of business against the Falcons. I didn't think they would beat them by that big of a margin, but they did. They looked well put together. They played with structure. We got the quarterback. We got the receivers. The offensive line played great. Our defense got pressure on the quarterback. And, you know, we're a sleeper right now. And the guys celebrated in the locker room. They had a good time after this win. And they should be enjoying, you know, the fruits of their labor right now after everything they've went through in the offseason. So, you know, they flew under the radar, didn't get talked about a lot, but they made a statement week one. So right now I'm going with the Philadelphia Eagles atop the NFC East. Everybody else just got to catch up. It looks promising, but they got to catch up.
Mike, when you mentioned Daniel Jones, he's not you, he's not Lamar, he's not Kyler. But because he's white, and can run. Skip, it's like a white DB. When you see a white cornerback, Jason Sehorn, people are oohing and aahing because they don't see that. Scott Case, I think the Washington football team has one on their roster. It's so few and far between that we see guys outside to be able to do. So to see a guy run like it was like Steve Young in the 80s, in the 90s, he was the only one that could do that. When we saw it, you're like, man, Steve Young got wheels. I tweeted last night, man, Daniel Jones can scoot.
But we didn't even know that from college.
No, I didn't know that.
He ran 4.8 at the combine.
I didn't know he could run like that.
No.
I didn't.
And, Mike, you see, he's pulling away from DB. The DB, the little safety tried to get, he's walking away from him.
Okay, remember,
Collins couldn't catch him.
He's 6'5" tall.
Yes. Man, look at this. Man, he about to break Landon Collins about to pull a hamstring.
Whew.
Go ahead, Mike.
That's what blew me away about that play. Landon Collins not being able to catch him and having... And then I started to think, is that the reason he's not in New York anymore? Because that's where he started out at, and he's on the other side now. And I got outran by Daniel Jones. Got a lot of respect for Landon Collins as a safety, but you got to make that play.
Yeah, now running away, Lamar Jackson pulling away from you, Kyler Murray pulling away from you, okay. But this guy's really thought of as a pocket quarterback. Most of these guys are thought about as pocket quarterbacks. But for me, Mike, I like the Eagles. I like what I saw the Eagles. But I can't, you know what? Can I really buy into them? Because Atlanta's going to be really bad defensively. I don't care what anybody say, Atlanta has not recovered from 28-3, Mike. You watched them over the last several years. That defense has progressively gotten worse. They got a few good pieces, but it doesn't matter. Dan Quinn was there. They've had a lot of different minds, defensive minds, and nothing is getting resolved. So for me, I'm really like, okay, I like what I saw. Jalen Hurts performed phenomenal. Devontae Smith, Jalen Reagor, Kez Watkins. They got Ertz. They got Goddard. Miles Sanders. They got nice pieces. The offensive line is finally healthy. Lane Johnson. They got Brooks. They got Kelsey. Kelsey. And they got the big left tackle that just paid a lot of money to, Skip. They look good.
Yep.
But I'm like, are they really this good or the Falcons this bad? I think the Falcons are going to be bad, but I'm liking what I'm seeing. Daniel Jones showed me a little something last night that if you protect him, and his biggest thing is he gives the ball away. That's his problem, Skip. He can make every throw on the field. He's just like, here, take it. You hit him, he'll give it to you. And Heineke, I like what I saw with Heineke. But I don't know about you, Mike, but I've been very disappointed thus far in what I've seen with the Washington football team's defense. I thought they would be better. Yeah. I just watched the team the opening day get the ball back with 6 minutes and 43 seconds. And they ran the clock out against that defense. You got to give them back. Give it credit now, Skip. I'll give them credit last night because they needed to keep them out of the end zone, keep the Giants out of the end zone. And they gave them three, and they kicked the field goal, and they held them, and they ended up kicking the field goal to win the game. But right now, since I got the field, I don't really have to pick a team right now. I feel very good. I feel very good about my five cases that I'm going to be sipping on.
Mm. My turn. So back to Michael Vick's first point about Philadelphia. It's going to come down to who has the best quarterback. And as a lifelong Cowboy fan, I do not fear Taylor Heineke. I know he had his moments last night. I do not fear Daniel Jones. He had his moments last night. And for 6'5", he's got easy speed. Like, he looks like he runs 4.5. But I don't fear him long term. I have been a Jalen Hurts fan for years. Shannon knows this. I fought for him when he was in college. I fought for him before the draft, and I applauded the Eagles for trading up for him in the draft because as soon as they got him, I said he will be a better performing quarterback. I'm not saying in a vacuum that he's better than Carson Wentz when you look at tangibles. But
well, in the vacuum, okay, he might be better now.
Hey, he might be better. But to me, the only quarterback I fear, other than my quarterback, obviously, is Jalen Hurts, because he is the real deal. He is serious business. That team will go as far as Jalen Hurts can take them, yeah. And I think it's going to come down to Dallas and Philadelphia for the division title.
Well, then I trust Philly.
Okay.
Now, the question is, saw last week, Mike, we saw the 49ers defense. We thought they were going to be pretty good. We saw Jared Goff go get 338 yards and 33 points against that defense. So, really, how good is it? The thing with Jalen Hurts, Jared Goff got the yards, but Jalen Hurts, you better make him, Skip, make him a thrower. Don't let him become a runner and a thrower. Guys like Michael Vick, Mike, I love you, but I'm going to make you throw the ball from the pocket. I ain't letting you get outside. I'm not going to let you run and then keep me on my heels, and the next thing you know, you running 55 yards, the next thing you know, you outside the pocket, throwing it over my head. I'm going to keep you in that box so I can keep my eyes on you, and I'm telling him, level off. Do not run past Jalen Hurts, because if you run past him, he's going to jump out the window, and he's going to be gone, and he's going to look like Landon Collins chasing Daniel Jones last night. So you better not run past him.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, right now, you got quarterbacks like Hurts and offenses across the National Football League where, you know, it's run and pass. You know, they can beat you with the run, they can beat you with the pass, zone reads and everything that comes along with it. And Jalen Hurts just happened to be a guy who can run and pass. So you can't really game plan for him and say, I'm going to shut him down and make him pass the ball against us, because once you start to do that, they hit you with a couple of concepts, then they running it. Now you got the defensive coordinator in the bind, and that's just what it is. You know, that's just the framework of the offense. But it's just not about Jalen Hurts. Devontae Smith is an asset that he can lean on. He creates separation. He's going to give problems to the defense. But let's just be clear, this is not the Atlanta Falcons defense, the San Francisco 49ers. It'll be a different type of pressure, not just in terms of the game and how it needs to unfold. Pressure up front, pressure in the secondary. You know, it's going to be a different ball game as far as the competitiveness. So this will be a good test for the Philadelphia Eagles. Can't wait to see how they respond, especially after the big win last week.
So, Michael, I think your Eagles will win this game at home against the 49ers. And I think the 49ers are on the verge of a quarterback quandary, depending on how healthy Trey Lance gets. But I wanted your input on this because for the first time so far this season, Jimmy G voiced a little frustration last week with having to share some snaps with Trey Lance. They drove it all the way down to the 5-yard line. All of a sudden, he's like, Trey Lance is going to come in and throw the touchdown pass?
Yeah, we told you that.
Yeah, okay. Well, he doesn't love it.
Yeah.
Michael, how do you feel about that? Would you not love it if you were in his shoes?
I wouldn't like it at all, because the more Trey Lance come in and have success, the more the fans going to be cheering for him to come in and be a guy who can take over the offensive side of the ball. You know, Jimmy G has a ton of pressure. And like I said last week, it's just a different football reality for this guy. It's not the easiest thing to do to come into a game and play a game knowing that the guy who's going to, you know, be your predecessor is on the sideline and waiting for you to make a mistake. Now the pressure is magnified. They tried to, you know, go to a two-quarterback system in the preseason. That's just not going to work. Rhythm is everything. So Jimmy G just has to perform at a high level. Any slip-ups, unfortunately, he could be getting a hook.
Guess what, Mike? I agree. He should be unhappy with having... But guess what? If you don't mind me asking, why is Trey Lance in San Francisco? Give me one reason why Trey Lance is in San Francisco. Because Jimmy G can't stay healthy and he turns the football over. It's his fault that Trey Lance is there. So why is he upset? If you'd have stayed healthy, if you stopped turning the football over, they wouldn't have traded up to get Trey Lance. They mortgaged their future because of you. And but you, man, be mad at you because you've been staying hurt. Your first year you get there, you tear your ACL. And then last year you have an ankle injury. And what do you do in between? Turn it over. We know you win, but you turn it over too much and they can't count on you. Your durability, your availability. They say, nah, we don't seem enough.
You know where this is heading.
Yes.
It's heading to Trey Lance.
Yes.
Okay.
Obviously, but like I say, Jimmy G got the ball in his hands. Everything is in his control. There's no excuses. And you don't want it any other way other than to have no excuses when it's all said and done, because ultimately you make all the decisions at the line of scrimmage, and the success of the San Francisco 49ers is predicated on how well he played.
Mike, he's always had the ball in his hands.